Hey, this is the Anvil you have always seen me using. It weighs 80 kilos or 175 pounds. And this beast is my new Anvil. It weighs 290 kilos or 640 pounds. Now, let's make a base for it and I'll tell you a little bit more about the Anvil and the base later. Alright, so as you can see, this anvil weighs 290 kilos, it's dated 1904 and is made by Firminy. The shape with the double horn is known as pig style anvil and is typical of European anvils, and in fact the manufacturer Firminy takes the name of the town Firminy, located in southern France. This industry was running between 1876 and 1960, producing all kind of cast steel parts and tools, and of course anvils. And well, I absolutely love this anvil. It looks just as massive as it is, and I'm very happy I was able to buy this from Anvil's Planet, that is a collector of anvils and blacksmithing tools here in Italy. And in reality, I got this a few months back, and since then I thought a lot about what kind of base to make for it. I considered all the options, from the classic walnut log, or fabricated wood poles, or even a box filled with sand, and at the end I decided to make a reinforced concrete cube and glue the anvil on top with construction adhesive. Concrete bases for anvils are a bit controversial, and I would definitely advise not to make one for small anvils, as the impact force from the hammer would probably break the concrete over time. You can think of it like a jackhammer. But in this case, the anvil is so big that the forces I can apply with hammers are not going to be enough to overcome the inertia of the anvil, or at least I think so. If you think I am wrong, let me know, and we will see anyway. Now that I can start using the anvil.